GOP candidate in blackface being supported by all of her white friends. Let's put up the picture, full mass here. Isn't that something? GOP allies are defending an Arizona candidate after photos of her in blackface, and I got another one of her in brownface. All of this surfaced online. The candidate is Mary Ann Mendoza. She is running in the Arizona House of Representatives election for Legislative District 9, covering West Mesa and other areas. Now, I want to explain something, because there are always people who push back, some authentically so. They do not know the history. What's so offensive about blackface? Let me give you the background. Stage plays in the United States of America. The people who went to them were so racist that when black actors and actresses were allowed to actually perform in stage plays because of their extreme talent, those black actors and actresses had to wear black makeup, black paint over their black skin in order to engage in the industry of theater. The reason is because white people took offense to the natural black skin of those in the performance. So in order for them not to be offended, the black actors and actresses were mandated to put black paint over their face and over their body, so that they could appease a white audience. That's the background. And then the features would be over exaggerated to fit the traditional sentiment and racist, bigoted sentiment of the white consumer. I hope that background clears it up. In these photos, she's wearing blackface. Let's put it back up. And as she said, Aunt Jemima costume. Mendoza has not yet made any public statements because what the hell can you say? She also did brownface. Let's put it up. All right, there it is. Blackface and brownface. Okay. Let me give you some background on candidate Mendoza. Mendoza was one of former President Donald Trump's angel moms. She started speaking out about illegal immigration after her son, Mesa Police Sergeant Brandon Mendoza, was killed in a head-on crash with an undocumented immigrant in 2014. While the photos surfaced on Twitter this month, some of the photos of Mendoza appeared on her deceased son's old Facebook page and post dated October 2011. She is in blackface while wearing that costume you saw, and she is in brownface in the Native American costume and post from a 2012 Halloween party. She's been doing this for a while. Let's put up a picture of who's defending her. US Representative Debbie Lesko, Arizona, is defending this person and continues to endorse Mendoza. In an email statement, she said, and I quote, "Instead of focusing on decade-old Halloween photos posted by liberal opponents right before an election, voters care about a secure border, common sense policies that will keep Arizona strong. That is what voters will get with Mary Ann Mendoza." Let's put up Kathleen Wynn. Okay. This is a supposed friend of Mendoza and former congressional candidate said, and I quote, "Her heart is pure and she deserves our full support. Whatever makeup she wore is no worse the drag queens." Look at that. How ironic is this? There's more. Lorena Austin on the left, let's put it up, and Seth Blackman on the right. The two Democratic candidates running against Mendoza released the following joint statement. It says, and I quote, "These recently released photos of our opponent are a display of violent racism. These photos are disgusting, hate-filled, and unfortunately part of a pattern for Mary Ann Mendoza. Both believe the photo should be disqualifying to this candidate." And they're right as far as controversy connected to Mendoza. There's more. In 2020, she reposted a series of tweets promoting anti-Semitic conspiracy theories, which led to her removal from the Republican National Convention. Damn, she basically got removed from the KKK, which led to her removal shortly before she was scheduled to speak. She later apologized, stating that she had, and I quote, not paid attention to the whole message. That does not reflect my feelings or personal thoughts whatsoever. Isn't it interesting that the party of personal responsibility all of a sudden cannot find themselves responsible for a damn thing they do? Everybody gives them an excuse. Everybody provides cover, barrier, safety for their extreme and insane behavior. But when it comes to, I don't know, let's say a very poor person who has a need for a meal, all of a sudden it's their fault. They gotta pull themselves up by the bootstraps. Their decisions created this. They must bear the penalty of society. But when it's one of them engaging in insensitive and insane behavior, all of their surrogates come to their defense so that they can avoid responsibility and never have to be accountable to the communities that they offend. Ms. Dahl, thoughts here?
You know, I would say vote, you know, yeah. Especially Arizona. I mean, I know Georgia also like huge elections, but the Arizona GOP, this is not surprising. The candidates they've put forward, the candidates they're standing behind are really scary. And it is a border state. And we've had that sheriff come out of Arizona that was horribly, you know, racist. And so it's so important to vote right now. The GOP governor candidate, Carrie Lake, it just there's so much. You know, I wish I could say it was only this person, how horrible her actions are. But I'm afraid that there's like a ton of the Arizona GOP right now. And people really have to come out and vote. They can start voting now. Early voting has already started. Don't wait.
Well said. That is it. The power of the vote. You are part of the board of directors. You are a voting member. Make sure you exercise that right.